Regarde l'eau qui coule, si paisible, le printemps se déroule. Dans l'air tranquille, le soleil qui s'étire.
Okay, so welcome to St. Petersburg, Florida. Today we're going to mix up some batch of sourdough in a 150-year-old dough trough. So we have everything done in our mise en place. We'll get the flour in here and get started. Now this goes back at least 100 or 500 years. We'll show you some photographs of where this is being used. So the way that we do this is we mix, the flours are mixed in here, and we just make a well on each end. And then what we'll do is we'll add our water. And today's bread is going to be made up at a 75% hydration. And then we have our starter. This is a mixture of plain white dough starter with some rye in there. It's about 35% rye to give it a little more sourness to the bread. We'll get all of that out. Okay. So what we do first is we'll take the starter and we'll just mix it with the water. We'll get it nicely separated out in here so that once we start mixing in the flour, it'll come together really nice. Now I think the Italians had it right where they, as you're making pasta, you keep drawing in the flour and make a slurry. Think of it as just you're making a roux in reverse here, so we just keep drawing this in. Mixes up quite quickly. Now this is a 10 kilo batch. It'll make 680 gram loaves. And there we go. Start it together, come together. As we get it fixed, then we'll start using the see how quickly it comes together. This is about a half batch for this trough. I mix up to 150 breads a day in this trough. It goes together quite quickly. It's really nice for the rye breads because they're so sticky. Of course, you gotta love sticky hands because you're gonna have that all the time. And if you're first starting out making artisan breads, even with your own fresh milled flour, it's always good to mix by hand so that you get a sensation of where the hydration should be in the dough. Because if you use a mixer, you'll find that unless you're using a double hydration technique, that the flour will not absorb as much water. Okay, so we can see we'll just clean up the loose pieces here. Okay, so you can see we've got a nice sort of dough. We're not even going to cover it. We're just going to let it sit here for 5 minutes and then we'll give it its first turn. As we make more turns, you'll see that the dough really comes together quickly. Okay, so we're back after 5 minutes. We'll see how much this has already come together. And what we're going to do is we'll just get some wet hands here. We'll just work this dough out a bit. We'll give it its first turn once we release it from the get everything all together. So it's just a matter of flipping it over. And you'll see by probably the third turn that this is quite nice. You just make sure there's no loose rye pieces out of the canoe. Good there. Just give it a splash of water. And I'm going to let it sit for another 10 minutes, give it one more turn, and then at 30 minutes, we're going to come back and add our salt. And that's going to get our bread all nice and ready to go. Okay, so we're back after half an hour. As you can see, the dough's relaxed quite a bit there, and we're going to add the salt. I like to use diamond crystal salt because it's evaporates quite easily. So we'll just sprinkle that on there a little bit. Get that mixed in, and then we'll add the rest. And I use the pincher method. I just put it like that, and then we're going to give it a fold. Salt. You want to add it all in one spot. Be careful, we just add it in sections. And you can feel the dough tighten up right in your hands here as you keep working it. The other advantage of doing several turns over the next 2 hours is that it also help to distribute the salt and keep the temperature of the dough nice and constant. Nice thing about Florida in the winter time is we can be an ambient baker where we can bake without having to use the fridge. Although the fridge helps to in the production so that your breads go in the oven without getting overproofed, especially if you work in a small setting like I do at home. Okay, we're very good, so that'll get transferred to the tub, and that's it for today. Okay, welcome back to Camelot Breads, where this is the second day. What we've done is retarded these in a fridge at 55 degrees for 16 hours, and as you can see, the beautiful color, and we've made a couple of different, we used a different basket. And here, this was in a classic Bannetton. And of course, you can see the crumb shot gives it a nice loose crumb on the breads and beautiful color. So, well, I hope you enjoyed the presentation, and we look forward to doing some more videos for you. Thank you.